Time while you were gone?
Well, we lost some members.
they're on TV.
Their TV program. Well, the week before last, as you all know, I vetoed a joint resolution which would have prevented the sale of defensive missiles to Saudi Arabia. And I understand the vote on my veto was scheduled in the Senate for this Thursday at 4 o'clock. I'd like to stress once again how important I feel it is for you to sustain my veto. I want all of you to understand that this vote will have a profound effect upon our relations with the Arab world, not just with Saudi Arabia. If the veto isn't sustained, it'll seriously undermine our foreign policy objectives throughout the region. The sale is clearly and without question in the interest of the United States. Quite simply necessary and indispensable to the execution of our foreign policy. And I'm counting on you in the Senate for your support. Most people don't seem to be aware, stop to think about it, we've had a relationship for more than 40 years, a sound and a security, mutual security relationship with Saudi Arabia. And it's been a great benefit to us as well as to them. So, that is for openers here, and I'll now pause while my friends...
Do you think you'll get it, Mr. President?
Helen, you've just heard my impassioned plea here.
I heard your plea, but I wonder what your head count is.
Have you found that 34th vote yet, sir?
I'm not going to comment. I'm just superstitious about that sort of thing.
Nice, thank you.
What did you think of their TV performance?
Fabulous.
Did you give him any tips?
I was probably going to beat the Wheel of Fortune.
Damn right.
Mr. President, do you think that some members of the press should be prosecuted for security leaks as Sister Casey has suggested?
Isn't a case of what we may think. There is a law that was passed, I believe it was 1954, that's very specific, not just about the media, it's about anyone who makes public information which can be dangerous to our national security. And I would think that all of us are bound by that law.
Lice, thank you. Let's go.
Yeah.
They're still shooting down there, come on.
Oh, you were late.
You feel like you're sick. You might prefer to ride. Did you have a good time?
George, I don't know. George, I don't know whether you were hiding behind those people when I finished my remarks, but now that they're gone, you can have a few comments on Saudi Arabia sailors. You were on my schedule.
Well, as far as the last question, though, is concerned on leaks.
I'm sorry to catch you waiting.
No problem. How are you? Good to see you. Nice to see you again. Good Meredith.
Hello, Meredith.
Thomas.
Hi, how are you?
And that's Bentley.
Hi,
Bentley. Hi.
Thanks so much for that lovely cake.
Will.
That was a little surprise.
I think you three ought to
Why don't you come around
and us here.
Get a little picture with him.
Yes, sir, Will. There. A smile. Thank you, right? And just then for you a little souvenir so you won't forget us.
Thank you.
And
it's one of the radio graphs I got.
In this box is a jar with this seal engraved on it, and it's filled with jelly beans. And just because you probably won't want to open that before you get home or someplace, why, here is a sample for each one of you of what's in the jar. All right.
Okay. It's a lot.
I'm not saying it's a lot.
Well, there's a little more that's in those sacks. Right.
Thanks so much for giving us your time, please. And I appreciate the wonderful honor of working with you.
Well,
the best experience of my life. Thank you, sir. I'm not leaving voluntarily, but it's been a wonderful experience working.
Well, thank you. All right. Well, goodbye, little lady. Nice to see you.
Say thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
You're welcome.
Mr. President, okay. Thank you, sir. Bye-bye.
Staff, you know this guy. He's not often on this side of the camera. Ron Geisler, who's the executive clerk. Al Nagin, who's head of the telephone service office. Ann Higgins, your pen pal.
How are you?
He's
fine.
Say, I've got a word for you, too. If you get a letter from someone I know you've been corresponding with, why, I have to warn you about her.
Okay.
Mary Rose, who's the director of personnel.
Nice to see you.
Gene Lamb is the administrative officer for the White House.
Nice to see you.
Biff Henley keeps the records.
Hi.
He's helping your library. And Billy Dale is a travel officer. And then...
Well, all these press are following you around the country.
All right. You can steer him to the wrong place sometime.
Okay. Yeah, Carol McCain is the head of the business office.
How are you?
Nice to see you.
Yeah, my secretary is Cindy Rexford.
Good to see you.
And Claire O'Donnell, my sister.
Hi. Well...
A team photo.
Yeah.
You want us to call her in?
But by the way, just she's in this house where there's digest and wasn't aware of all the correspondence. I just sent her a contribution, so if you hear from her, that's what happened.
Okay, everyone else here. One more. Don't look so unhappy, thank you, sir.
That's the friends
and parents. Yes. You know the travel story that probably would affect anyone. The fellow that came in, bought his airline ticket, said, "Now I want that bag to go to New York, and that one over there to go to Miami, and this one here to Syracuse." And the clerk said, "We can't do anything like that." He said, "You did it last week."
Billy doesn't do this.
I just thought that maybe they could lose baggage, maybe sometime they could lose the press.
travel. Just take the whole plane to Syracuse.
Only when he's going south.
That's right.
If you haven't heard the news, this is a victory celebration. They upheld my veto.
Did they really?
Nothing to spare. 34-66.
Oh, wow.
Boy, that was close. Great. Yeah. Congratulations.
Fantastic.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
for your time, sir.
I'm so familiar.
Yes, I just keep walking around. This is Ursula Pearson, who's the financial manager for the Executive Office of the President. Keeps our books.
Thank you.
Adrian Gillen, who was just married last week and who runs all the libraries in the complex.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Ray Kogat.
Good to see you again.
He's the personnel officer for the Executive Office. And here's the computer genius, Jules DePisa.
How do you do?
It's a pleasure to be here. If I'd have known he was going to be here today, you know, I would have brought down that little thing that they just gave me out there, this little Seiko clock that can tell you a little map of the world, and then you push buttons and find out what time it is any place in the world.
Doesn't work.
I just don't understand how to do it.
Bring it down.
We'll take care of it.
This is Arnie Trotter, who's my general counsel and keeps us out of trouble.
Hello there.
Get yourself a speechless attorney. Thank you.
And Dr. Paul Romani, who is the head of administrative operations.
All right, well, I think we'll get it.
Understand.
That's it. Great. Thank you.
Okay, that looks good. Very good. Right at the camera, that's it. One more. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is a day of celebration, isn't it? From that to 2 o'clock today. Senate upheld my veto of the Saudi army.
Oh,
congratulations.
I see him very
good. You haven't lost any yet.
64-6-34, just the minimum number.
Do you think it had something to do with the breakfast?
What?
Did it have anything to do with the breakfast?
I don't know.
I'm sure that part of it.
Probably you cooked the eggs.
I told them this morning while I was sitting in his room, I couldn't resist now that they're on television. Yesterday I was asked for some tips by some of their colleagues as to, you know, from television and what to do. So I told them, learn your lines, don't bump into the furniture, and keep your mouths closed in the kissing scenes.
Thank you very much.
Great pleasure.